Steve Winwood and a good example of a promo video, which gives us another chance to look at the way music is suddenly being shown on TV through a film we made for RPM just before Christmas. Well, groups have got fed up with being packaged to fit into programmes like Top of the Pops or what have you, so instead they're now turning to a new wave of video directors to put pictures to the music in a very different way. Oh, videos like those aren't made by TV companies like the BBC and ITV. Instead, they come from independent studios, mainly in London's Soho. They cost between £6,000 and £40,000 each, and that for a song lasting only about 3.5 minutes. Their life is short, they'll only be used for the 5 or 6 weeks the song is climbing the charts. The man who directed those videos is Keith McMillan. He started off designing album sleeves, but was then one of the first to get involved in the video market. Today, Keith McMillan is working for Trillium Television, producing a video for the Bristol-based band Famous Names. It's really a mixture of the band's ideas and the director's visual interpretation, but the bill goes to the record company.
Right. I think my job really is to take a current single or a concert or whatever and visually represent the music that's either on the disc or on the live concert in a way that portrays to the viewer what the band is trying to do, what the record's all about. And if I can make the visuals flow with the music nicely, then I think that's what my job is. Coming to two. Two. Up you go, that's nice. Coming to one on the vocals.
Remembering where they are.
One!
There's a limited usage on British television for the amount of money that's spent on actually making them. But where it is very important is internationally. Nowadays, a lot of single records are released internationally, simultaneously. And, of course, the artist concerned can't be everywhere at once, so we tend to produce the videos in London or in Los Angeles and send them out internationally so they can be used on Australian television, New Zealand, Japan. It saves the artist flying around the world, and also the artist has an image on videotape that they're happy with.
Close up on one, please. Count of one, one.
Close up on. If there was a Cannes Film Festival then and promotional videos, which one would you submit of your own?
Well, my favourite one at the moment, although it does vary quite a lot, my favourite at the moment is the McCartney video I did called Coming Up, for various reasons. One is I think it's a good product, it does its job very well indeed. And it excites the viewer, which I've had a lot of feedback on. It was a very technically difficult job to do. We broke a lot of new technical ground and had a lot of planning, because basically we had a band which consisted of 11 people, 9 of which were Paul McCartney and 2 were Linda McCartney doing the backing vocals. And to get them all looking like a band on set with all the lights changing and everything was a very, very technically difficult thing to do. It took us 3 days to shoot it, and I'm pretty proud of that one. The Save Me video for Queen was the fact that we had a little bit of run-up time on that. We had about 5 or 6 weeks' notice on that, which enabled us to use animation, which was nice. Animation, it took 4 weeks to do the animation, and we could pre-plan it. We worked on a complete storyboard. went into animation and did it. And that was nice because I very rarely get the chance to spend 5 weeks doing something. I usually probably have about 24 hours.
That's beautiful, isn't it? And directors like Keith McMillan are likely to become even more influential with the growth of the home video cassette. Acts like Blondie and Gary Numan have already recorded whole albums as video packages, so who's going to pay nearly £5 for an LP when for a tenner or so they can see the group as well? Big changes ahead, I think. And so to episode 5 of our serial, The Shallow Grave.